the law of disqualification in Georgia does not require either of them to step aside. It's not a disqualifying event for two prosecutors to have a relationship.
Allegations of corruption and conflicts of interest are swirling around about Fani Willis and her prosecutorial team as the Georgia election interference case against Donald Trump and his co-conspirators heats up. Now, there are rumors that Willis had an improper relationship with Nathan Wade, the chief prosecutor of the case, and that she accompanied him on two out-of-state trips. In fact, some of these trips included out-of-country tropical vacation trips. So what exactly are the allegations and how would they impact the overall Georgia election case against Donald Trump? Well, Mike Roman, a Trump co-defendant, alleged in a court filing nearly 2 weeks ago that Willis and chief prosecutor Nathan Wade have been in an improper clandestine personal relationship and that Willis may have broken the law by hiring Wade as a special prosecutor and then allowing him to pay for vacations across the world with her unrelated to the work on the case. Now, Roman unsurprisingly called for the prosecutors to be disqualified and for the charges against him to be dropped. That is unlikely going to happen. I mean, the charges being dropped. But there will be a hearing to decide what the fate of Fani Willis will be as a result of some of this information that's been coming out. Lawyers for Wade's estranged wife filed a motion in their divorce case that included credit card statements that appeared to show Wade had purchased airline tickets for himself and Willis to Aruba and San Francisco. It's unknown whether Willis paid him back. And Willis alleged in a motion to basically squash a subpoena seeking to depose her in Wade's divorce case that Wade's estranged wife, her name is Jocelyn Mayfield Wade, was colluding with those who are seeking to basically disrupt this case against Donald Trump and the co-conspirators. On Friday, Georgia GOP Chairman Josh McCoon circulated a 2020 video of Willis saying that she would fire any employee who sleeps with a coworker and promising not to date people that work under me. And there are other issues too, including Wade's lack of prosecutorial experience in the type of case that he's the lead prosecutor of, namely the Georgia election interference case. And then there's also some issues in regard to how much Wade has basically billed for his services compared to other prosecutors in that case. And here are some more details on that.
Now, Mr. Wade, as you said, his primary area of practice was personal injury law. Not, in my view, qualified to handle a major complicated racketeering case. Nonetheless, he's been hired along with two other lawyers from the outside to come in and help the DA. Nothing wrong with that. But if you look at the amount of money they've been paid and they've billed, Mr. Wade has billed $650,000+. The others have billed $70,000 and $90,000. So there's a question of, is he working nine times as much as the other folks? The other big problem though is there's clearly a relationship of some nature, we don't know exactly, between the DA and Mr. Wade. And some of that money is being used on travel that the DA is accompanying him on. So some of the money that the DA's office is paying out to Mr. Wade is now being used for personal purposes for the DA. So there's a real potential conflict of interest there. Really important to keep in mind, we have a hearing in that case set for February 15th. So we'll get more information then, but at a minimum, it looks terrible and it raises legitimate questions about the DA.
So in summary, the argument, Cenk, is that she is having an improper relationship with Nathan Wade. She then hires him to be the lead prosecutor on this case. He proceeds to bill $650,000 as he works on this case, which is far more than the other prosecutors working on it. And then the allegation is that some of that money was then used to go on trips with Fani Willis. That is what they're alleging. Obviously, more information needs to come out and an investigation needs to happen. But what are your thoughts on all of this, especially if they end up being true?
Yeah, so first of all, improper relationship in the office. Look, that's not my business. It's a normally a local issue, a small issue, etc. It depends on a million different pieces of context. But in this case, there is something that I am concerned about, which is, okay, it's one thing if you have a relationship with someone at the office. It's another thing if you're having a relationship with someone outside the office and then you hire them and you send $695,000 of state taxpayer money to them, then we've got a significant issue, okay? really significant issue. Now, having said that, this is really important, guys, because the lack of logic drives me nuts. So they're like, oh, Fani Willis might be doing something inappropriate. That's why Trump is innocent.
Yeah.
What? No, it doesn't have anything to do with Trump's case. Whether Trump is innocent or guilty has nothing to do with whether she's using taxpayer money to take vacations to Aruba, right? That's a different problem. And if you say, hey, we should look into that and hold her accountable, I totally agree. Hey, by the way, MAGA, you see how that's how it works if you're not a hypocrite. You say, oh, she's on my side, but I want to hold her accountable. He's not on my side. I want to hold him accountable. That's called being consistent. You might want to look into it.
But Cenk, like the thing that I'm even more bothered by, okay, what you just mentioned is something we should be concerned with 100%. But the thing that I'm most bothered by is that it appears that she hired him as the lead prosecutor, knowing that he has expertise as a personal injury attorney, but doesn't have expertise in prosecuting the type of case that they're trying Donald Trump on.
Yeah, look,
and that's
guys,
like so unbelievably irresponsible.
So I wasn't trying to judge that too much because sometimes you never know the details. Maybe he had some background or not. But now that all the details have come out, no, you don't hire a personal injury lawyer to prosecute the former president of the United States on one of the most important cases in the country. And it's an historic case, a personal injury lawyer. Look, guys, I'm not dissing personal injury lawyers. It just that doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
It doesn't make any sense at all. So it's like hiring a sports agent or something. What? Yo, he's technically a lawyer. Yeah, technically, but why are you hiring him instead of a prosecutor with expertise in this? So no, it doesn't make any sense.
And
so,
remember, the Georgia case is incredibly important because should Donald Trump get elected, which there's a good chance that he will get elected, he would be able to pardon himself in the federal cases, but he would not be able to do so when it comes to a state case, meaning the Georgia election interference case.
No, I'm now, the more we talk about it, Anna, the more angry I get at her. Like, what are you doing endangering potentially the most important case in the country because of a personal relationship? Are you nuts? And did you not think that it was gonna get revealed? Look, she hasn't said anything about it. She hasn't even denied it yet. That means she definitely did it.
This
Let's
is,
keep
yes.
it real.
And these rumors started swirling weeks ago, and she has not denied it. She hasn't even directly addressed it. She indirectly addressed it. And I wanted to give you some information about that because those close to her, her allies, are pretty irritated with the way she's handled this. Several Willis allies have said privately they were disappointed with her remarks last weekend at a historically black church in Atlanta, in which she described herself as flawed and imperfect, but did not directly address the allegations. She defended her decision to hire Wade, calling him a superstar with impeccable credentials. Some have also criticized Willis's claim during that speech that race is the motivating factor behind the attacks against her or the allegations against her.
No.
They were disappointed with that response as well. But again, like, it does, sure, it brings up some ethical concerns, especially when it comes to the amount of money that was billed. But I just want to reiterate that the most concerning part is that you have someone who's not experienced in RICO cases trying Donald Trump in one of the most historic and important election interference cases, certainly in American history. And so this does serve, and the other concern, Cenk, is that this is going to serve as a distraction, right?
Of course it is.
Conservative media is covering this wall-to-wall coverage. And so a longtime ally of Fani Willis says that, you know, maybe there needs to be some recusals here. So let's take a look at what he has to say about this.
The challenge with Mr. Wade remaining on this case is that it's become a distraction from what is one of the most serious alleged conspiracies in American history. Poppy, we all heard that January 2nd, 2021 tape when Donald Trump said to Georgia Secretary of State Brad Raffensperger, just find 11,780 votes that didn't exist. That's where the focus needs to be. We need to get the case on track, moving quickly. A trial has been requested for 2024 and not discussing this relationship. Not mandatory, but he should do the right thing.
So he's calling for Wade to step down from the case. Notably, he did not call for the same thing for Fani Willis. But I do think that's the right thing to do. I mean, in the very least, I think Wade should step down from this
case. Yeah, I don't know that she can even step down from it, because I have to look into that, because she has an elected position. But for him, it's a no-brainer. Look, there's two things that are no-brainers. One is Wade should recuse himself instantly. What are you doing? What are you mucking up the case for? Yeah, I know it's irrational to say, hey, we got an issue of potentially corruption here, but is it? It doesn't have anything to do with, by the way, not only does it not have anything to do with Trump's case, it also doesn't have anything to do with any other case. Like, if Fani Willis was using him on a murder case, should we just let the guy go, even though he's a murderer? Because they were having an affair, it doesn't make any sense, right? But is it confusing people and endangering the case regardless? Yes. Should he recuse himself? Of course. And second of all, when you use charges of racism when they don't apply, you do great damage to the cause of fighting real racism, and you're incredibly selfish about it. So I have no sympathy for you, okay? So going out there like, oh yeah, just because I'm sleeping with this guy and funnel $700,000 of taxpayer money to him, oh, now it's because I'm black. Get out of here, man. That's nonsense, total nonsense. So we've been trying to fight racism here for all these years. And anytime these selfish people come by that are almost always powerful people, when they're called out on their wrongdoing, oh, what can I hide behind? No, I have no tolerance for it.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.